I'm here with Jeremy Bray, Denmark Cricket's head coach. Jeremy, please tell me a little bit more about your role with the Danish Cricket Federation, please.
Listen, my primary role is obviously the national head coach of the senior side, but also head up the whole coaching infrastructure of Danish cricket. And of course, you know, we haven't got a lot of coaches over there, also work within the coaches, you know, with all the underage groups as well, so kept very busy.
I can tell. There seems to be a lot of ICC cricket activity at the moment. What events are you preparing for, and what are your targets for 2020?
Yeah, we've got potentially three events. The first two we certainly are, you know, competing in. First one is in Malaysia in March. The middle.
Wow.
Yeah, fantastic. We're very much looking forward to that. That's the World Cricket League Challenge Group A, which goes over a three-year cycle, and this will be the second part of that cycle. So, you know, we head to Perth first before that, so we're very excited about that. The second ICC event is the European T20 qualifiers, and the winner of that group will go into another qualifying event in September, which will hopefully, the winner of that, or the first two teams, will go on to the, you know, another qualifying stage.
Very good level, eh? Yeah. Amazing. Very good. You played international cricket for Ireland for a number of years and played and trained all over the world. How have our cricket facilities compared with your experiences elsewhere?
These are, you know, fantastic. I don't think I've, you know, the ground itself is just amazing. It's a proper international ground. Everything about it, you know, we've thoroughly enjoyed. It's as good as where we've, you know, where I've been, that's for sure. And the net facilities as well, they've been great, you know, especially for this time of year. You know, it's just coming into, you know.
It's like summer.
It's like summer, you know.
No, in January.
Outstanding. And just the whole place is a lovely little, you know, tranquility to it. And, you know, definitely looking forward to come back again.
Great. Great to hear that. Thank you. Obviously, high-performance athletes need feeding and to be comfortable. What has been the feedback from the group regarding these aspects of the camp?
And to be honest, they haven't really said too much, which is really probably a really good thing. You know, we just had a review session there, and they really thoroughly enjoyed their time here. So that obviously, you know, without directly saying, you know, how good the facilities are, they, you know, I think that's a real positive feedback. Then, you know, even
of
without
course.
Saying too much, you know, I think what I think. Well, I certainly really enjoyed is just how calm it is around here. And you can see that with the guys going about their work. It was just very, you know, just done in a really nice, calm way instead of hundreds of different people and groups being around here. That's been a
to charge the batteries and disconnect.
Absolutely. It's a fantastic place to be.
Great. This was your first visit to Desert Springs with the cricket group. Do you have any plans for the Danish Federation to come back to train here next year?
Oh, without a doubt. Listen, you know, if the money's there, we'll certainly look to come back again. And hopefully this time we look to play some games. Oh, without a doubt, we'd want to come back here for sure.
Great. That's lovely to hear. Thank you very much. Thank you, Jeremy, for taking some time to chat to us. And have a safe journey back home. And good luck this season.